Dear student, welcome to EPG Pathshala. Today we will discuss the topic rainwater harvesting under the paper water resources and management. You must be wondering that why do we have to harvest rainwater when we have such an immense availability of water on earth? Well, let's start the topic with the learning objectives. Need of rainwater harvesting, traditional and modern rainwater harvesting techniques, quantitative estimation of harvested rainwater, quality of harvested rainwater. We know water play a crucial role in maintaining life on earth, and 71% of earth's surface is covered with water, but only a small fraction of this 71%, that is 0.014%, is available for human use, and this very small fraction is shared by world's competing users. With the continuous growing human population on earth, the demand for clean water is also increasing, which further increases the stress on available freshwater resources. This leads to the declining of per capita water availability worldwide. Going through the data, per capita water availability is reduced from 5,177 cubic meter in the year 1951 to 1,608.26 cubic meter in the year 2010. Rain is the cleanest source of water. Annual average precipitation of country is about 1,100 mm. That drains a total volume of 400 million hectare of rainwater. Therefore, harvesting and conserving rainwater can be considered to meet the challenges of freshwater availability for population demand. Rainwater harvesting is not a new concept. Since antiquity, India has the oldest and largest irrigation system in the world and has the history of practicing rainwater harvesting. The oldest and the largest known irrigation and rainwater harvesting system was created by Chola kings in Tamil Nadu. People of Rajasthan are traditionally been practicing the rainwater harvesting since ancient period. The Bavris and Jalahar, also known as step wells, are the oldest rainwater harvesting system and widely used in different part of Rajasthan, Gujarat, Karnataka, Maharashtra as well. In different part of the country, different techniques are traditionally being practiced, such as Shivganga tank or Brideshwara temple tank collects rainwater used for the famous temple and also for irrigation activity at Tanjavur. The next technique we have among the all traditional practices is Zabo, that is also known as impounding of rain runoff. It is a common practice used extensively in Kikurma village, Nagaland. The runoff collects in pond at the middle terrace. The pond, that is Jabo, receives rainwater and used for paddy plantation and also for the fish rearing. The bunds on the side of ponds are used to grow herbs and medicinal plant. This way, the traditional farming system also help in conserving the forest in the region. Bamboo drip irrigation. Bamboo pipes are used to capture and transport the water to drip irrigate black pepper cultivation in Meghalaya. Many bamboo pipes of varying diameter and length are laid to manipulate and control the flow of water. Among all the other techniques, as we have discussed, that the people in Rajasthan, they use a well-structured traditional practice also known as Bavris. These are the community wells and mainly used for the drinking. It can hold water for a long time because of almost negligible water evaporation. The oldest and deepest known Bavri is also known as Chand Bavri, located in Abhaneri village, Jaipur. Tankas are the covered underground tanks developed primarily for tackling drinking water problems. Also, the kunds are well-structured and maintained underground storage tank that collect rainwater through artificial catchment diverted to underground storage tank. Among the modern techniques for rainwater harvesting, these techniques are broadly designed to serve two main purposes. First, for the collection and storage of rainwater for direct use, and the second is for groundwater recharge. However, these two can also be practiced in combination, where the collected rainwater is stored for direct use and the excess of it can be directed to groundwater recharge system. A modern rainwater harvesting system comprises combination of various components and processes. These are catchment surface, conveyance system, pre-storage filtration, storage container, pumps, post-storage filtration and treatment, post-storage distribution. However, the system is not limited to these components only. The requirement of different components vary depending upon the harvested rainwater utilization. For surface water storage, it includes the capturing of runoff from rooftop and from local catchment. Most common example of surface water storage is rooftop rainwater harvesting system. Therefore, a rooftop rainwater harvesting system requires catchment, which is the collection area which directly receives the rainfall for provides water to the system. Next is coarse mesh. It provides at the roof to prevent the entry of debris. Then gutters. These are channels installed all around the edges of the sloped roof to collect the water. These are semicircular and rectangular shaped drains. Conduits are the pipes used to deliver the rainwater to the storage system. First flushing, first few minutes rainfall is called as first flush, as it carries the heavy load of pollutant collected from the atmosphere and the catchment. Therefore, first flushing is a valve devised to check the entry of runoff from the first spell or flush of run to the system. Next, we have the filters. A filter system is a chamber filled with fibers, coarse sand, gravels and charcoals, etc. to remove any debris or dirt particle from the harvested water before it enters the storage tank. These filters can efficiently remove any color, silt, clay and microorganism from the water. Storage tank is a tank to store the water. Overflow pipe is installed on the top of the storage tank to remove excess of water from the tank during the heavy rainfall. We can have a look at the schematic representation of above ground rainwater harvesting system. For groundwater recharge, groundwater recharging is an indirect method of rainwater harvesting. The basic principle of groundwater recharge is to restore the aquifer. Therefore, groundwater recharge system involves the installation and construction of variety of structures such as recharge pits and trenches. Let's take recharge pits. Pits are constructed for recharging the shallow aquifers. These are constructed with the dimension of 1 to 2 meter wide and 3 meter deep, backfilled with the filter material, that is boulders, gravels and coarse sand. Recharge trenches are constructed when the permeable strata are available at shallow depth. The trench may be 0.5 to 1 meter wide, 1 to 1.5 meter deep and 10 to 20 meter long depending upon the availability of water. Dug wells or groundwater can also be recharged by using existing dry, abandoned or unused dug wells that can be utilized for recharged groundwater. The water pass through filter media before putting into a dug well. Similarly, the abandoned or running hand pump can also be used for recharging the shallow or deep aquifer if the availability of water is limited. Water can be diverted from rooftop to hand pump through a pipe. For any successful rainwater harvesting system, it is important to quantitatively estimate the harvested rainwater. But for quantitative estimation, certain parameters are required to know. These are rainwater endowment of an area, which is the total amount of rainwater received over an area, which can be calculated simply by multiplying the plot area and the rainfall height. Next is rainwater harvesting potential. The amount of rainwater that can be effectively harvested is known as rainwater harvesting potential, which can be calculated by knowing the value of rainfall of the region and the area of the catchment and the runoff coefficient. Next important parameter is the volume of storage tank, which is the capacity of a tank to hold the water. A rainwater harvesting system must be designed in a way to fulfill the water requirement of users during the dry period. Therefore, the volume of a tank can be calculated as per the given formula. We have seen that for calculating the rainwater harvesting potential of a storage tank or of a catchment area, runoff coefficient is important. So, runoff coefficient is a value or the total amount of water that our catchment area can hold. A surface can lose the collected rainfall due to spillage, leakage, and evaporation and many other means. Therefore, runoff coefficient is the value that represents the ratio of runoff to rainfall, and it gives a value of maximum amount of rainfall that a surface can hold. Say for example, if a surface has a runoff coefficient of 0.9, it means that the surface can hold 90% of the rainfall. And because runoff coefficient of an area depends upon the topography and the catchment structure, slopes, soil and various other parameters of the region, the value of runoff coefficient vary. The value of runoff coefficient of different surfaces vary, the value of which are given here in this table. Rainwater is generally considered as the purest form of water, but quality of water that is harvested through rainwater harvesting system depends upon environmental conditions such as topography and weather. Secondly, these also depend upon the material used in the construction of the system. Different contaminants of a rainwater harvesting system broadly fall into the following three categories. That means a rainwater harvesting system or the rainwater collected through the rainwater harvesting system can collect the contaminants in the form of physical, chemical or the microbiological. Among the physical contaminants, it includes dirt, dust, ashes, debris and the plant material. For chemical contaminants, it includes reactive chemical species emitted from automobiles and industrial activities. Whereas microbiological contaminants, they consist bacteria, protozoa and the viruses. These contaminants can come from various sources which are atmospheric pollutant, also known as wet deposition. When rainwater came in contact with atmospheric layer, it collects certain pollutants and which are known as wet deposits. Atmospheric deposition accumulated on the roof surface, also known as the dry deposition, when the rainwater came in contact with the roof materials. Material used in the construction of the roof. So, these were the contaminants or the source of contaminants that a rainwater can collect. Therefore, improper maintenance of rainwater harvesting unit can affect the water quality and pollute the water with different contaminants. Therefore, proper maintenance of rainwater harvesting system is essential. Proper functioning of rainwater harvesting system and the maintenance of harvested water quality can be achieved by fabricating or coating of catchment area, smoothing the surface of catchment area, avoiding material that are prone to leach such as zinc, copper in roofing system, covering all the inlets or mouth of drain pipes with nylons or wire mesh, avoiding the exposure of stored water in storage tank to sunlight, as sunlight can promote the algal growth. To facilitate cleaning of tank, an outlet pipe should be fit and fixed in the tank at the bottom level. Installing first flush device in the conduit before it connected to the storage container. To avoid the bacterial contamination, stored rainwater must be checked for microbiological contamination using hydrogen sulfide stripes. For this, a clean water bottle should be filled and incubated at 25 degrees centigrade to 37 degrees centigrade for 24 to 48 hours. If the content turns black, water is not fit for the drinking. And if the content turns into any color other than black, it indicates that the water is free of bacteriological contamination. Proper treatment and maintenance of hygienic condition should be done to avoid development of any pathogen in stored water. The stored water treatment include chlorination, boiling, sunlight disinfection. For chlorination, calcium hypochlorite can be used at the rate of 1 gram per 200 liters of stored water. Therefore, we can add calcium hypochlorite at this rate to the stored water to disinfect the water. Secondly, we can use chlorine tablets, which can be added at the rate of 1 tablet of 0.5 grams per 20 liter of the water. Effective boiling of 10 to 20 minutes can also be used for disinfection the water before drinking. Solar disinfection, also known as SODIS, it can be done by exposing the water filled in clean glass or plastic bottle to the direct sunlight, placing on the black surface for 6 hours or more. Government of India is promoting the conservation of water. National and state water policies have also recognized the role of rainwater harvesting in maintaining the national water security. As a result, the state government and the urban development authority of different states have made the development of rainwater harvesting system as mandatory in their region. These are some examples of the state which have made the rainwater harvesting system mandatory in their areas. Dear student, in this module we have discussed the importance of rainwater harvesting to secure the water demand, different type of rainwater harvesting systems which include traditional practices used in India since ancient period. Knowledge of these traditional practices are important to develop the modern rainwater harvesting system. We have also learned the quantitative estimation of rainwater harvesting system and the maintenance of water quality in the rainwater harvesting system to avoid any serious health issues associated with the consumption of contaminated water, and also for working of the rainwater harvesting unit in the long run. Thank you.